My name is Nick Stasoulis, and I'm a hydrologic technician with the main office of the New England Water Science Center. In the screencast, I will discuss the basic field review procedures for a midsection measurement collected in RiverSurveyor Stationary Live. Let's start with the System tab. In the System settings, look over the tagline azimuth, which is only entered if the compass was used for angle correction, and check the salinity as well. The azimuth should be the heading of the cross section in the direction of the right riverbank. Confirm the track reference is set to System, the default, and the depth reference is set to bottom track or vertical beam as appropriate. The discharge method should be set to midsection. In the field notes, confirm the water temperature and ADCP readings were within 2 degrees Celsius before the measurement began. If there were discrepancies, a user input water temperature could be entered here, but this should not be routine. This temperature will override the ADCP temperature. Most of the other information in the System tab is supplementary and does not affect discharge computations. Next, we'll review the Transect tab. This tab is likely the most efficient place to determine major data quality issues. Start by scanning the contour plot for any irregularities in depth, velocity, ice information, and other information displayed. Also ensure there is a black space at the top of each station, indicating a screening distance was entered. Ideally, no station would have more than 5% of the total flow. Scan the angles indicated using XYZ, where the unit is aligned manually, or ENU, where the compass is used to correct for angles. Inconsistent angles could be attributed to user error in how the unit was held when using XYZ, or due to an incorrect tagline azimuth or compass errors when using ENU. Ultimately, you should ensure indicated angles are reasonable based on observed flow conditions and make hydraulic sense. Starting on either edge, scan through the stations using the left-right arrow keys and look over the SNR and velocity profile plots. In the SNR plots, look for large inconsistencies, including separation between beams and spikes in one or more beams. In the velocity plot, look for reasonable agreement of the measured data with the extrapolated data, and for a general, reasonable profile shape vertically. A separate screencast will cover evaluating extrapolation in more detail. Double-clicking on any station will bring up a dialog with settings for that station. This is where you could edit the station location, water surface type, ice information, transducer depth, screening distance, coordinate system, or profile extrapolation method. The Time Series tab will allow you to quickly review parameters from each station plotted together in one view. These parameters could include vertical beam and bottom depths, water temperature, pitch and roll, battery voltage, profiling modes, and many other settings. Again, look for consistency values that are reasonable based on the channel conditions and a hydraulic knowledge of the site. When using the Time Series tab, be sure the plots are scaled appropriately and be sure to change the data being viewed by right-clicking as needed. A few examples of useful things to check here are vertical beam depth versus bottom track depth, instrument alignment, and magnetic error. The Samples tab is another quick way to check each station for consistent processing settings and data collection results. This table includes station information like the coordinate system used for each. You should also review other tabular data like flow angle, number of cells, station discharge, mean velocity, and depth. This table is customizable by right-clicking on the header. Note the percent discharge is not computed unless a rated discharge is entered in the System tab. The Discharge Measurement Summary, accessed by clicking this icon in the toolbar, is another quick way of viewing lots of important measurement details. Scan the System Setup and Discharge Calculation settings and the uncertainty values provided. Look over the station details and ensure the water surface type, temperatures, depths, flow angles, and other fields are consistent if you haven't reviewed them already. After conducting this preliminary review, address any issues you might find as needed. Some issues may be resolved by simply changing software settings or entries, such as an incorrectly entered station location, but some issues may require data to be recollected. Once the measurement has been satisfactorily reviewed, save the discharge summary file to import into SV Mobile. In the next screencast, we will show some examples of issues commonly identified in the RiverSurveyor Stationary Live software.